doing anything big and bold in the world takes extraordinary risk. And we've become so risk adverse. People are concerned about their stock price plummeting or congressional investigations or their reputation. And in the United States, we are a nation that exists because 500 years ago, thousands of people risked their lives, gave their lives to cross the Atlantic, and then hundreds of years ago, risked their lives again to cross the Great Plains and open the West. You know, we are a nation of risk takers. And I've become enamored with the idea of creating a vision and pulling the right people together and just saying, anything is possible. We can do anything. Let's get the right people, the capital, the technology, and slam it. So I founded a company called Zero Gravity Corporation that does weightless parabolic flight. The goal was to take Stephen Hawking up to experience zero-G. I love the idea of taking the world's expert in gravity and giving him the experience of zero-G. And I took a huge risk in doing it, but that's a different story. I got two calls, one from our aircraft partner and one from a government agency. I won't mention who they are, their initials or the FAA, but ultimately they said, you're crazy, you can't do this. Zero-G is only for able-bodied people. And I was told over and over again by everybody, listen, you are risking your company. You're gonna injure this guy. He's got very weak bones, very weak heart. He's been wheelchair bound for 40 plus years. 6 months later, I was able to finally get the approvals in place. When I offered him the chance to fly in zero-G, he said yes on the spot. I knew he had a passion about space. He had an amazing time. If you look at the images of him, you see this just giant grin on his face. That's why we started the company, to be able to do cool things like that. And so as we are on the verge of the greatest exploration ever, opening up space, we need to be able to take those kinds of risks.